Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I'm Griffin Nolan here first, commentating the very first home game for boys basketball.
Well, the first home game that we're live streaming.
That's what I just said.
We'll pass it off as the first game.
Yeah, very home. First game.
Yeah, very first game.
We're talking about 0-6.
0-6.
The other team's 0-5 though, so it's a face-off of the Titans.
Titans, yeah. Say. I think they're pretty evenly matched.
Oh yeah.
We have 21 Kendall, who's a sophomore now, running against pretty much the same height as 33 for his senior on the other team.
Dage.
Interesting not to see Khalil in the starting.
Yeah, Dylan playing point guard instead of Khalil.
which I found interesting, and I'm kind of surprised Miguel is also starting.
So Christian has the ball for Guhomi, pushing down court, gave it, handed it off to Dylan. And so far this game is going pretty steady. And
Christian's going to give it back to Dylan, and Dylan's going to look out for Miguel.
Miguel, a freshman on the team for
good
varsity.
Passing to Dage.
Oh.
Dage with the air ball, but 24 gets the rebound.
Number 20 for Classical has the ball, moving it to number 1. I do believe is a senior who is pushing up the court.
Yeah, number 1.
Made his way all the way.
I saw number 1 during pregame. I didn't think, I thought he was actually a coach.
Really?
He's so good.
Yeah.
Number 1's really good.
Oh,
so, but it didn't count. It's okay.
Guhomi should really watch out for number 1. Keep the players.
They should watch out. Really, for everyone. We don't have any seniors on the team this year. Our entire team pretty much graduated last year. And it's tough, you know, having to rebuild the team. We'll get through it, though.
We're still growing. And
completely.
I think this first season is going to be a good warm-up, and next season we'll bring it through.
Yeah. Fouled by Dylan there, it looked like.
Yeah.
Oh, a travel, actually, by 24. Would have been a foul by Dylan otherwise.
Christian, you know, off to Dylan, number 23.
Awkward pass.
And oh, that was a good pass.
Oh, oh
but
pass
no,
there.
Juan gets it, pushing his way all the way to the down again.
All the way up.
In, into the basket. Number 1 is going to be a...
And Khalil's coming in
a
already.
A force to be reckoned with.
I'm not too sure why Khalil didn't start.
But I think he is coming in the sec here.
Yeah, he is. It's going to be a foul against Classical. I think it was on number 20, but I'm not sure.
But who is he being subbed for?
Missing Dylan, yeah? Yeah, Dylan.
Oh, all right.
Dylan's not too sure why he kind of put his hands up in confusion there.
But now closing the game.
Yep.
Who's a junior, I believe. All right.
Dylan a little frustrated. I'm not too sure about what.
And
Khalil looking
the
for someone to pass to. There's not really anyone open besides Christian.
We have a 2-0 Classical lead here.
Khalil switching sides.
Bring it back.
Oh, a bad
with 33.
Oh,
reversed again. They had the communication. Going for the three.
Bad shot.
Hits the rim. Recovered by number 24 for Classical. And off to Kendall, then back to Khalil.
Interesting pass.
Pushing their way up the court again. Hopefully to score some points.
Khalil looks like he wants to pass to Miguel. Miguel's not really too in too much space, but he's going to give it back to Khalil, yeah.
Number 20 for Classical.
Yeah, there's a foul on Khalil. I don't know what that
little
was.
Shot,
but okay.
You know, not much. Good it does.
Yeah.
Strange.
Cool.
Very cool. Very
yeah.
Cool.
Weird flex, but okay.
Is it white ball? No, back ball. Classical.
Yeah, it was a foul on Khalil.
Ah.
But smart foul.
Number 1 has it for Classical. 20 open.
Shouldn't they they shouldn't be leaving him wide open.
Khalil
like
now
that.
Pushing up the court, forced to Miguel. Passes it off to number. Oh, it's a bit of a fumble and it's out.
Classical. Still a very even game, 2-0.
Classical's in lead.
Yep. But it's pretty even. Classical really look like they're the team in control right now, though. The Guhomi's got to sharpen up their defense a little bit.
Having ball advantage, yeah. But once Classical gets used to it and they start making the shots, then that's when they'll be. That's when it's time for Guhomi to start picking it up.
Another travel there, this time by 33, his senior. I believe he's a center. But yeah, Guhomi, they're going to need to start trying to really work the ball into the area and trying to get some shots off because they're really not.
Miguel pushing forward
with the handles.
He's good. He's fast.
Yeah, he is.
You can get into the key a lot faster than most of our players can.
Dage struggling for the ball.
But 34 gets it, and it's knocked out by a white black ball.
That was interesting. I thought there would have been a foul there on Dage. He had about 4 guys around him. Is what it is.
Yes, not. Number 1 has the ball again.
Number 1.
Like he's
going to
be a key player. Khalil, really tight defense.
Khalil staying on him, though.
No foul caused. Oh, but he weaves
good defense by Khalil. That's another travel. That's their third travel of the game. They're really going to have to watch out for those travels.
Classical?
Yeah.
And it's because they're moving too fast.
Yeah, and number 1, he seems to be a little bit selfish. He really could have passed it, but elected not to. Which tries to swipe the ball from Khalil. But
all right, Christian has the ball now.
Very high pass there.
There you go. I'm assuming he should pass it. Yep. Yeah. He looks like he crowded in the key. Number 33 has the ball. Passing it off to number one now for Classic.
He looked like he wanted to shoot there, Miguel.
Give him time. Kendall. He's going to be subbed in here in a sec.
Yeah, he's going to get subbed in for Dage.
Or for Classical is pushing his way towards the basket and makes a shot. Beautiful shot.
Good defense there by Khalil. But
Khalil pushing his way back up the court. A 4-0 lead for Classical.
Yep. Dage in a bad position there.
Kendall being subbed in for 22.
Interesting.
I think they need Kendall's height right now.
Dage is taller than Kendall.
It's true, but one kind of slid out.
They're not even getting the ball into the paint, though, which is cause for concern for Guhalmi, because that's where they really normally score their points. At least
last year, that's where
they were really scoring their points. Of course, Christian was, you know, shooting threes occasionally, but
and then Michael, who was in the key most of the time, but we have some pretty promising-looking players who are coming.
Yeah.
Wow. Couldn't make the layup.
Really surprised he missed it.
Number four got his...
He got his hairband a little bit.
Yeah, there's a cluster going on here. Wow. Pass to number four. But he walks
hairball.
Three. I believe it's... still Classical.
Ooh.
And they missed three shots.
It was actually a good shot there by 24, but it just hit the outside of the rim, not going
in. Bring the heat. Kendall
good
coming
to Kendall.
In. Oh, but he made it even with the shove.
Right in. And
that's the kind of plays we're looking for Guhalmi. We need to stay fast.
Easy pass. I think Khalil gave him the pass, and it was just a really clean pass, and it was an easy shot for him.
Well, it makes sense, because Khalil and Kendall were on the same team last year.
That ball went out.
They had that communication.
Khalil
pushes way back up the court. He goes away.
But he
found recovery. Amazing.
Oh, Khalil's hurt, though.
Hopefully, if he's out already, that's not good for...
He's already got a brace on that knee, though.
Hopefully that knee doesn't get dinged up anymore.
He's good.
All right, good. Let's go. Keep it strong.
Yeah, he's got a brace on that knee. He's got to watch out for that. Don't want him getting hurt. Right there, a little bit of brightness from Khalil, if you will.
Here we go. Is it the first foul of the game?
Yep. Looks like he's going to come up for the free throw here.
I don't remember how consistent Khalil was with...
It's not too bad. Off target there.
A little bit off center.
Timeout for Guhalmi.
Timeout for Guhalmi. Commercial breaks. We'll be right back.
It's the most wonderful time of the with the kids jingle-belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful.
We're back, Guhalmi.
Coming back from the break. Guhalmi, things that I've seen so far, I mean, the game's 2-4, and we've had quite a few minutes played. Good defense from both teams and a lot of fouls from Classical, mainly in the...
Travel looks like it is a really close game.
Yep, Khalil really needing to make these free throws.
Just make it.
Yep.
Back ball now. I do think that the speed for Classical is going to be a problem for Guhalmi because, 33 has the ball. We see a little bit of struggle here. Wallen going for pass three. Oh, and he swishes it. Kind of devastating. On his Classical's turnout here is
from deep.
Pretty insane.
Miguel going all the way through
the away game.
Like a travel.
Kendall almost made the layup.
Definite
I think Kendall
foul.
Got hit in the head.
Yep, Kendall's going to get two free throws.
Thought so, yeah. Ooh.
Yeah, it looked like a head hit.
Yeah, Kendall was kind of rubbing his ear there for a sec.
Surprised Christian's still in the game. He hasn't been subbed out yet. Kendall.
Great job.
Free throw.
Still,
there goes Christian.
Costco having a 4-point lead, 7-3. But I'm sure Guhalmi can pull back in the end.
That's interesting. Christian looks like he's playing the shooting guard, if I'm not mistaken, and point guard positions when he switched out with Khalil there. Khalil obviously a point guard, and I believe Christian's a shooting guard.
Possibly utility?
Yeah, I mean, guards play similar positions. Oh!
Number 24 using some vulgar language. Not very happy with how that play went. I'm
surprised that wasn't more of a technical.
I guess Khalil was kind of backing off, not wanting to cause any problems.
Yet 24.
24 is rather upset. Getting really holding on to Dage.
Oh, Kendall, though.
Trying to keep it in. Black ball now.
Kind of really frightened to get that ball back in, but it was already out.
I do think the refs should watch out for number 24. He's getting really, really handsy with some of our players. Hopefully that doesn't cause... Hopefully that doesn't,
like, the whole class problem later.
Let's see how this goes. One is really fast compared to the rest of his team.
Okay. Oh, where was the coverage?
Yeah.
When
he misses up the lay... Oh, and we get the struggle on the ground with Dage and number 31 for classical.
Guhami's defense, though, let's talk about that for a second. They had four guys on one player. They really
being
need to
subbed in sophomore for Miguel, freshman.
They really need to watch. Guhami really needs to watch the pressing because they're pressing way too hard on one player. They need to be
spreading it out.
Yep, they need to be guarding one person instead of having four people on one man. Awful pass there. Nicks off a player's finger, but Guhami just really needed to improve on that defense. Khalil going to pass into Kendall here, and Kendall's going to take it up. I'm assuming he's going to pass it up.
I believe that's, yeah, that's Dylan.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, it's okay.
Dylan.
Khalil shoot for the three.
Yeah, Khalil wanted to shoot that.
Oh, three. Kendall pushing through classical.
A smart assist there by Khalil to pass in. Classical taking over.
I do think since 33 is not on for the team, they don't really have that height advantage, and Kendall is really going to be there.
The rough defense. Yeah.
Classical pushing forward. Number one is just aggressive in this game. Keeping it still in. Stepped out. White ball now.
Out of bounds. Looks like Christian's going to be coming in for
Kenny. Who just got on. Oh,
Khalil. Interesting.
Let's see how this goes.
Okay, so now Christian's playing point guard. See, that's a little confusing. I mean, they're guards. They can switch out pretty easily. But, Classical being really aggressive, but they're just not draining their shots. Khalil with the smart assist there while he was still on to Kenny. Not Kenny, sorry, Kendall.
Yeah. Travel. I didn't even notice that.
Interesting, but they need to just be working the ball into the key more. As you can see, I mean, they have 6 points. They're not shooting threes. All their points are coming from the key, so they need to really work that key more.
Yeah, if Classical was more consistent with their shooting, oh, great. Great job for Guhami keeping the ball away from basket. Classical always pushing forward. 24 for a three.
Over air ball. Kendall with the rebound.
Kendall's just getting the.
Yep, and here's Dylan pressing up. Out to Kenny. Dage.
Ooh,
barely got a hand on that. Here's Kenny, he's going to shoot.
For a three.
Looks on. Oh, just off. And
oh, 24 bumping into Kendall out of some. Here's some gritty plays there from Classical.
He's not going to get it, though. Oh, he is.
Great layup.
Bad defense by Kenny there, just letting him go right past him. Kenny
20 is a lot larger than Kenny.
Oh!
Knocking Kendall to the ground.
Yeah, Classical. The
Kendall's just taking a beating. This is not good.
The refs need to get a hand on this game because Classical is really playing aggressive.
You see 24 and 20 really just pushing it in. Oh, and Kendall's being taken out. He was doing really well, but I think they're just targeting him now. All right, let's see. Christian's going to be passing it. Hopefully, but it's packed immediately out again.
No one's open.
Their defense
Miguel's hanging out on the outside. He's not really getting into space, and Khalil's getting constantly covered. He's going to pass to Dylan. Yeah, Dylan's wide open.
Miguel to Dage.
Dage
made a perfect job. But Mr. Charles,
hey, Dage, we're on rebound. Good job, Dage.
Great recovery there.
8-9. Guhami really hanging on, and like I said, they need to work that key.
Here
they are.
Ooh.
That was close.
Wow. He is fast. We really need to watch out for Classical speed. Miguel swipes the ball, pushing his way down the court. Great plays by freshman. Oh, but it's recovered by number one. And makes the layup. Senior one for Classical is quite happy taking on freshman.
Oh.
Score 11-8, Classical lead. Hopefully they don't score any more points. It's quite an even game.
Well, not really pressing. Christian with good defense on number one there.
Oh, what a pass. Oh, brilliant shot. I do think that, is it Dylan? I believe it's Dylan. He's watched the ball a little more.
Guajome need to cover number one.
Well, one is their, probably one of their strongest players, being a senior and all. Oh, we do have Dage got a foul.
Yep, he's going to get a couple free throws here. I don't think, normally tall guys aren't that great from free throws, but we'll see. I stand
cooked. Stay cooked, yeah. Good job.
Thank you, Dage.
Kendall being subbed back in.
Yep. 4-point game. Guajome need to really watch number one because he is the star player for their team.
Seems that way.
90-13, though.
He's just fast, and he consistently makes his layups. And the rest of his team...
And not only that, he's getting really good assists. He's just passing around the outside of our players, and he's just dribbling right past.
Like that. See? I think him and number two, one and two are watching.
Two people.
32 was just wide open. 24. Oh. Oh, but he couldn't make the layup.
Yeah, 24 missing.
Plays like that won't mean much if you can't make the shots. Two. We were talking about number two, weren't we?
Yep. He's really good from the three.
Ah, that's the end of the first game. And we'll be back after these commercial breaks.
A lot to work on.
It's the most wonderful time of the year. With the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year. It's the happiest season of all. Those holiday greetings and gay happy meetings when friends come to call.
Wrestling, we all know what it is, but do we all know how it works and where it came from? Wrestling has been around for as long as humans have been around. It is in the Iliad, the Bible, and has even been found in cave drawings in France. It has also been in the first Olympic Games. And has
We're back, homie.
Guys, imagine playing a home game, but your stands are taken up by the other team's fans.
I know, the turnout for Classical is quite astounding for it being a away game.
Like, I don't see any. I see like five people from Guajome.
Kind of unfortunate, but it does happen.
I've never seen it, especially here. I mean,
we're not a huge school, but
no. I mean, we're not small, but that shot was on too.
33 back in this game too, and they do have one. I think one's going to be in the game most of the time.
Yeah, he's probably going to be in the whole game.
See, they're just leaving people open, and they can make these layups.
Kendall fighting for the rebound there.
33 fighting his way through the key. But apparently,
they're calling for the travel. It did look like one. There were a few different fouls that even the coach wanted there, but none of them are getting called. It's a homie throw. I don't know why all the Classical players. Okay, yeah, there they go.
That was a little bit odd. What's happening here?
What is
going
on?
Black ball. Ah, I see. I see. Well, hey guys, don't forget, Wednesday night at 7 p.m. is the winter concert here at the gym at Guajome. How much are your favorite holiday songs?
Yeah, your brother's going to be in that.
Yeah, he is first chair for middle school. Danger. That was bad. Oh, white. Yep.
Kind of whacked Kendall in the head there. That was definitely foul.
Back in this game, Christian's going to be hitting it with Khalil.
Yeah,
see how this goes.
Khalil kind of just surveying his options. Dylan looks like he's open. I'm assuming, yeah. Yeah,
Dylan
he's
trying really to pushing it. Oh, but Kendall, ball kind of rolled off in there.
Oh, Classical doing a great job to get that ball back.
Number one, oh pushing God. It.
Number
oh,
one,
great
is
pass. 24 here for Classical. Taking a shot. Lift it. But Khalil,
number one just has a really great mind for basketball.
Oh, long shot. And he's still in.
He's really got a good mind for basketball.
He was pushing his way up the court. Speedy, but lost handling of his ball. Kind of astounded by... Oh, 33. 32, I believe. He's pushing his way into the key and makes his layup.
Yeah, he's just... 24 looks like he's a really strong player. Number one, like I said, he's just got a great mind for basketball. He knows where to play those passes. And you can see that. I'd be surprised if he...
He just knows where he needs to be. Oh, but
yeah,
Dylan...
Yeah, it's definite foul. Wow, a travel.
Interesting.
Coach complaining about the refs there.
I see some substitution here.
Dage coming in.
Dylan.
Khalil's coming out, and so is Dylan. Miguel and Dage are being subbed in.
What is... No, what Miguel's doing.
Oh, Lonzo came out, too.
Oh,
interesting. Kenny came in.
Oh, I see. Juan again with the ball. He's pushing his way up the court. He's easy as his breathing.
They can't get on the one.
Three. Ah. Got a foul.
He towers over everyone, but he... 33 can't really jump that high. I mean, he towers over everyone, but he can't get up too high. I see Christian, actually. Played here last year.
I see Classic looking for foul shots. That's how this goes.
Kind of wish we had him on the team right now. Instead of just standing and watching.
Indeed.
Christian?
Where?
He's right there.
Oh, Christian, yeah. I was talking about the Christian on the team right now.
No.
I was like, isn't he on the team though? Christian was one of our old senior players. Do you play point guard?
A lot of people. What? Do you play point guard?
Yep.
I believe, I've heard he's playing in college, not too sure, but a lot of people think that he was really the catalyst for that amazing go-homie success that we had last year.
Yeah, getting a great connection with the players.
CIS semifinals in Division 2, I believe. We did really good last year for the size of our school, but I mean...
But now we just have to build our way back
up
again.
Yeah, I'm just going to say that game last year, I went to that game last year at San Diego Academy. One of their players, he was already picked up by a college, but he was captain of the varsity football team and captain of the varsity basketball team. And he was picked up varsity for football by Arizona State.
There are some athletes like that that wander around.
But, I mean, he could have been easily picked up for basketball.
Christian?
No, the other guy.
Oh, okay.
Christian, too. Christian does play college ball, I've heard.
Except he was a great asset to Bohomi. Made great noticeable plays. But I don't think the spirit of Bohomi left with him. I think they still have it. They just need to get that connection back with the team. And then they'll grow from there. And then they'll start making bigger plays.
Some of these freshmen are they're really good players. Like Lonzo is good. I think, Miguel seems like he's not really too bad. I mean, they just really need to get some experience under the belt so they can...
I mean, freshman varsity, you're already playing against a couple seniors, and that can be scary as well.
I mean, number 33.
Yeah, we have that.
Number one.
It's kind of unnerving.
Number one kind of speaks for himself.
He's a Classical with an 18-10 lead. And the game is going by fast now. Khalil pushing into the key. Doesn't make the layup. Is that 32?
30
is being a very aggressive.
A jersey pull there by Christian. Wasn't called.
Oh, two missing
off his
I've
foot.
Seen that a few times now. He's kind of messing up his handling.
Three back in the key.
Oh, but
awful shot.
What is happening?
Oh, Khalil.
Going to get away. Ran into the ball again.
Lonzo.
Khalil. Oh, my goodness.
Extreme body on number two there.
That was kind of strange.
But number two went flying.
It does happen.
It was a foul on number two. Oh, yeah, blocking.
Yeah.
Fair.
That was strange. I was like... Well, there's a certain point where you kind of in his way.
Yeah, I thought they were going to call a charging, but they did not.
Ooh, they're beautiful.
Khalil really needs to get back in this game.
Because he was a great player last season.
He was really good last year. You know, he came off the bench, shot some threes, and he was following in Christian's footsteps. But I think Christian not being able to really tutor him makes a big difference in the team.
Yeah, I do think since, who was it? It was Ty, Michael... and Christian keeping that team occupied, Khalil found his little spot to make his consistent threes.
Agreed.
And so we needed the team will learn from that and they'll grow to play to each other's strengths as well.
Yep.
And
completely.
Oh, 33 with a great shot for Classical. But once our team understands that, we're going to be scoring high point games and taking leads.
12-20. The game's not too far from Guahomie's reach, but with things like that, they just really have to keep this game within their reach if they want to hang on.
Lucky Classical isn't making all their layups. One pushing back into the key again.
Number one powering upon just beyond everyone, really. No one can really figure out how to defend number one yet. I'm sure they'll do a little bit better.
He gets just really low.
Yep.
He's really speedy, too. Khalil looking for an opening to pass. Dylan seems wide open to me.
Yeah, he does.
But he pushes any and anyway.
Lonzo. Got through.
Lifts.
Another shot off the rim. And here's number one, being guarded by Khalil. Khalil's doing a good job of defending him, but you can only do so much against a player that's so good. Oh, Khalil with a good steal there on number two.
Good job.
Number two putting his head down in frustration.
Hopefully he can... Oh, great screen, but Kendall with the recovery making the layup.
Yeah.
Timeout on Classical. We'll be back right after these commercials.
In our high school. Let's see what our Guajome wrestlers are doing now and how they expect to do in the future.
I'm Brandon Raymer. I'm the captain of the wrestling team, and I'm a senior. I've been in wrestling for 7 years now, fourth year at Guajome. Last year, I went to Masters. I got third at CIF, had an overall score of 28 wins, 10 losses, and I also won league. I feel like we're going to be very successful. We obviously have a lot of new kids on the team also, so there's a lot of room for improvement and everything, a lot of underclassmen. But I feel confident that we should have at least 5 people go to CIF and place and continue on to Masters. Well, one obvious goal for the team is to win league, because that's obviously like constant competition every year. And for myself to place at CIF, win CIF, you know, go to Masters, place there, and make it to state. So, you know, 7 years of doing it, you can get old, but it always like renews, you know. It's always the awesome brotherhood that you have with everyone, your teammates, and the family bonding that goes on. So definitely would recommend it. So don't really get too bored of it that often.
My name is Austin Chacon. I am a senior. I've been wrestling for 6 years. I have
We're back, Guajome. Great to see you here. Thank you for tuning into the live stream. This Thursday is junior movie night at 7 p.m. watching The Grinch with Jim Carrey, one of my personal favorites.
Yeah, they're going to have pizza and some other snacks. Miss Gillette was telling us today.
Miss Gillette's the history teacher.
Indeed, from what I remember.
I haven't seen 11 play very much. He was on the court, sorry. He has a different...
Oh.
Is that a 3 by number 3?
Here's Khalil.
Khalil.
Giving the ball to Dylan. He told Dylan, come here.
Dylan was a point guard last year when Christian wasn't.
Yeah, he was developing.
Dylan has a lot of... He's looking... Having like he has a bright future. Hopefully that carries through. Was it a foul?
Yep, number 11. Shakes it off. He doesn't think it was a foul.
25-14, Classical lead. We'll see how the rest of this game plays out.
Yep.
Second. Both teams are making great plays.
Second quarter. Dage getting in. Oh, definite foul there.
He does get free throws. Which is what we really do need.
Yeah, and Dage was doing good on the free throws a little bit earlier.
We did see. Hopefully he can bring that energy back.
Yes. Oh, just barely.
Just barely.
Shout out to the Guajome crew who's with us here today.
We got
Gavin, Malia, and
Lena.
Mr. Amaya, and Lena. Shout out to Mr. Amaya.
Yeah, keeping this crew together. That cement.
Oh, great steal there by Lonzo.
He's pushing us all the way. Oh, but he ran too far.
It was too late. He wanted a foul.
Holland, number 30. Oh, tipped off by Dage. Great play.
Lonzo wanted the foul on number one there. It did look like number one did make a little bit of unneeded contact.
Lonzo, freshman?
Yep. 22,
yeah. For Guajome.
And here's number 30. Giving the ball a beating before he passed it.
Yeah. Oh, and doesn't make the shot.
Dave. Oh, travel.
Guess not.
Okay.
See Christian pushing up back to Lonzo. Oh, Lonzo got kind of tripped up there in the key, but no foul, no nothing. 33, realizing that he just needs to push forward. Brief Classical. Yeah, because he's going to pass. He does. Deliver 11, who...
Oh, just barely.
Almost makes the three. Would have been kind of devastating if he did. Pushed out. unfortunately was pushed.
Seems what good sports there.
They got some strange.
Imagine your team winning, but you still boo the other team.
Your own team.
Yeah.
Number four in for number one. I'm assuming they're siblings or something. Must have some kind of relationship.
Who are they booing?
Number four on their team.
What?
We're coming in for number one instead.
Really?
Yeah. Maybe there's some kind of relationship we don't know about. Obviously, we don't have all the information.
Yeah, something weird there. Oh, well, I mean, it's number one.
Number one. He's really in. Oh, a foul.
Anyways.
Kendall back in. Good thing, too. He was really making some great plays for Gahomi, and hopefully he can keep that going.
Interesting. Kendall, that's weird. Kenny just came on. It looked like I saw this happening on the sides, and I wasn't really going to say anything. Kendall was going up, but they called him off. Kenny went on, and now pretty much directly after, they're shoving Kendall on for Kenny.
Number four is fast, keeping up with Khalil.
Oh.
Shoots for the three. Oh, I almost thought from our perspective looking about to make it.
Yeah, not a good shot there by number four.
Three.
Oh, three wide open.
Does make the three.
They really have
pretty
to be
risky shots.
Yep, they have to be covering the area. They have to be watching.
I agree.
Dylan.
Dylan got knocked to the ground.
Oh, bad pass there, but number four is gonna get there.
Keep it in.
Just barely. Number three wanted the ball.
30 waiting patiently. Dylan covering. Oh, and knocked to the ground. What is happening?
Foul on Gahomi.
Black ball.
Khalil holding that leg. That brace.
Miguel coming on for Dylan.
I haven't really seen too much from Dylan that's really impressed me this game.
He's been covering.
And number one's back on, so their own fans are cheering. That's gotta hurt.
That's kinda gotta hurt.
Like everyone on the team.
Don't quote me on this, but I'm assuming one and four are siblings. And there's something there. But that's what I'm piecing together.
I don't know.
I don't
30 just came off for number one and they were cheering. So
this is strange.
Yeah. I think they just really like number one. I mean, and why not?
Ooh, oh, Dage tripped up. Miguel pushing his way on the court, kind of alone. Kendall back in the key, just where he needs to be. One gets the ball.
Kept it in.
Blocked by Christian. We have a cluster. Back with Dage.
Getting in.
Dage knocked him over 33. Dage is back on the ground again.
Oh,
travel. Rock ball.
Yeah. 33 is going to get a talking to. Ref just said stop. He knows he committed a foul there. He smacked the ball back in Dage's face, and it was a technical. Oh, no, I thought it was. Dage was going up like it was a technical.
But it is block ball.
Yeah. 33 smacked the ball back in the player's face and then laughed as he got up. And he's still laughing. It really should have been a technical. Gahomi bench is really quiet with some of these calls. And
one's pushing his way through the key. See, that is vicious.
Seems a little bit full of himself, number one. Not passing the ball to anyone.
Those are problems. Maybe he's just a senior and he's trying to get noticed by college. That is also an option. Kendall. Oh. Black ball. He was hit up by Dage, I believe. We have
the rest.
8 seconds left in the clock for this quarter, for this game.
Just before the quarter ends here, or the half ends, rather, there seems to be some really bad calls made by these refs.
Was a timeout called, or? I do believe a timeout was called.
Interesting.
Back to commercial break.
It's the most wonderful time of the year. With the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year. It's the happiest season.
Back in this game. 6 seconds, 5 seconds left on the clock. Honestly, they should just shoot it. Oh, number one couldn't keep the ball.
And he wants the foul. Of course he does.
Did he get the foul?
Are they going to give it to him? I'm assuming they are.
Of course.
The golden boy number one.
Gotta watch out for him, man.
Oh, yeah.
Just shoot it. They got 2 seconds left.
Bad shot.
Look at the shot. You're right. Halftime.
Yep. We're going to have some little halftime games going on, courtesy of Mormon,
our athletic director. It was a big help here. Shout out to him.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a halftime competition for you. I need two volunteers from the stands to shoot a three-pointer, a free throw, and a layup. When the kick is crossed, we have two volunteers. And you're not playing in college if you're going to do this.
I see one volunteer.
All right.
I see one volunteer.
Who wants to be the challenger? The challenger.
Yeah, facts. I'll go up.
And
where are you guys from? Are you guys from
Costco? Of course, here.
Yes.
There's no goalie fans.
Well,
in the
state. Let's go with the last. Alright, here we go. We're going to start in the middle, right there.
Cheeky.
Right?
They're going to give him a goal.
We're going to give you a goal. Well, you have 3 shots in front. You have to make a free throw. You have to make a layup and a three-pointer.
I'm just going
to
let this speak for itself.
Yeah, there you go. Get that shot. On the other chances, we're going to say 2 minutes. 2 minutes. Alright. Hold on.
Interesting to see that Costco fans just got their homie merch.
That's cheeky.
Okay, a little bit.
You gotta admire that.
But those are some great plays. Look at our athletic director, Mr. Mormon, there.
Great plays. That's a word to describe it.
Yeah, they're fantastic. Look, you see that? You went just like that.
No,
They were shooting off fireworks in the gym.
Yep. All right, let's see how this game is going to go. And we're going to go to commercial break. Be right back after these messages.
It's the most wonderful time of the year. With the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year. It's the happiest season of all. With those holiday greetings and gay happy meetings when friends come to call.
Wrestling, we all know what it is, but do we all know how it works and where it came from? Wrestling has been around for as long as humans have been around. It is in the Iliad, the Bible, and has even been found in cave drawings in France. It has also been in the first Olympic Games, and as a matter of fact, also in our high school. Let's see what our Guajome wrestlers are doing now and how they expect to do in the future.
I'm Brandon Raymer. I'm the captain of the wrestling team, and I'm a senior. I've been in wrestling for 7 years now, fourth year at Guajome. Last year, I went to Masters. I got third at CIF, had an overall score of 28 wins, 10 losses, and I also won league. I feel like we're going to be very successful. We obviously have a lot of new kids on the team also, so there's a lot of room for improvement and everything, a lot of underclassmen. But I feel confident that we should have at least 5 people go to CIF and place and continue on to Masters. Well, one obvious goal for the team is to win league, because that's obviously like constant competition every year. And for myself to place at CIF, win CIF, you know, go to Masters, place there, and make it to state. So, you know, 7 years of doing it, you can get old, but always like renews, you know. It's always the awesome brotherhood that you have with everyone, your teammates, and the family bonding that goes on. So definitely would recommend it. So don't really get too bored of it that often.
My name is Austin Jacone. I am a senior. I've been wrestling for 6 years. I have sort of a goal to just basically do the best I can. I'd like to place at some of the tournaments because I haven't been able to place, but generally I would like to just wrestle and leave everything on the mat that I can. So go 100% in each of the matches. For the team in general, we have a lot of young guys, so that looks pretty good for the years to come. Hopefully we can get some more younger guys in there. That's what we need. But it's a good team so far. We got at least, as much as it pains me to say it, smart guys on the team. So
Brian Haskell, I'm in 10th grade. I've been wrestling for a year. Well, since it's my first year, I'd like to win a lot. Basically, yeah. As a team, I'd have to say I would like to be either a test dummy to improve their skills.
So my name is Hugo Escamilla. I'm a sophomore, and I've been wrestling. This is my second year wrestling. I think I did okay last season. I did okay. I went to freshman county. I didn't place, but you know, I'm always working to get better. This season, I'm planning dropping to 138s, going to CIF, placing at CIF, and hopefully making it in Masters. My favorite part about wrestling is like the sport itself. It's like it's really fun. I like it because like it challenges me every day. It's not easy like basketball or soccer. You know, it challenges you. It's really hard, but you like, the most important thing is that like we grow as a family. This year, I'm actually excited. Even though the seniors left, a lot of people are really good now. They've improved from last year, and I am expecting our team to win league. Brandon, I'm coming for you.
So, I look forward to seeing you at all of our home dual meets and wish them luck as they go to tournaments. I've been Nick with GPA TV.
Whether it's not wanting to run or work out, wear funny looking clothing or sweat, many people's responses are, ugh, more PE. On the other hand, there's the people that like to run and maintain a healthy body. Some people aren't athletes like others, but you don't need to be athletic to succeed in PE, because it isn't only about working out and running. According to fitworld.org, PE improves your physical fitness, develops motor skills, teaches self-discipline, influences leadership and cooperation, and most importantly, it keeps you physically and mentally healthy. According to shapeamerica.org, 74.5% of the states require PE from elementary to high school. Only 6 states require PE in every grade. 28 states allow waivers, which for many means, yay, no PE. But is this really how we should react to physical education? Can this be changed? Does PE really benefit not only us now, but also our future? Let's go talk to some PE teachers to get their perspective on this topic.
Hi, Mr. Mormon, high school PE teacher here. PE absolutely helps you maintain a healthy lifestyle, teaching you the basics of nutrition, fundamentals of exercise, and it gives a student the broad aspects of sport, and maybe one sport a student's never done before, they get to try it in PE, and all of a sudden they have a love for the sport, they realize they could actually play it, and so it is absolutely beneficial for all kids to do PE.
Hi, I'm Mr. Tenney. I teach 7th and 9th grade PE here at Guajome.
We're back, Guajome. I'm Griffinola, just to remind you.
I'm Gunner.
And let's just see how the rest of this game plays out. Classical has a 27-14 lead.
Yep.
Oh, and we see the girls' basketball teams coming in.
Yeah, I see
from their
Nina,
game.
Sasha. Nina, Sasha, and Savannah.
Great block by Kendall. Oh, but he gets... Oh, a foul already. All right. I mean, we'll take it. 2 free points, potentially.
Right.
Potentially.
Kendall.
Kendall making.
Shooting. Trickles out. Oh, Christina's here too.
And now we wait patiently.
And
great shot by Kendall.
Yep, Kendall made the second one. I'm not sure what happened with the girls' game today. Number one.
Hoping to
one pass.
Costco ball pushing away towards the basket.
Wow.
Oh, great layup.
I don't know how he actually got that shot off. Guajome playing what is potentially their full strength lineup. And, oh, Khalil wide open for the three. Yep. Nope, it was just off.
Good shot. Oh, good wrestling there for the ball. Is it white ball?
Come back to that wrestling story.
Oh, 21 held on 33.
Was it out of bounds?
It was a holding from
on
Kendall. So 24 back with the ball. Into one,
what's
on
him,
pushes right up to the court. Passes his number four at the three.
Oh.
Ooh. Great shot. I do think the Costco fans are really hyped because Costco is a 0-5, right? I would be too. Kendall being kind of pushed around there in the key a little bit. But it's the black ball again.
Yep. Number 24 passes to number one. Number one is in so much space. 20. Foul on classical number 20.
Pushing is what I'm getting. Christian's ball for Guajome.
Oh, oh, another shot. Blocked, but he gets it back. What a great rebound.
One steals the ball from Dylan. Pushes way up the court. Probably going to push all the way in there.
Yep.
Doesn't make the layup. Gets the ball back.
He does not.
Christian pushing his way all the way to the court, hopefully making the layup.
Oh.
Oh, but it's recovered by Dylan. Getting pressured in by the key. And Khalil.
Oh, Khalil. Khalil didn't settle there when he went to take that shot.
Classical ball again. On the other side of the court.
Number one is getting shut down.
They finally realized that, hey, we need to pick out this player in particular. We need to cover him.
Khalil's getting mad about something. I'm not too sure what about, but...
Hopefully it doesn't affect his gameplay.
He says something, he's something every time. Khalil's telling Miguel to...
Pass out support from the crowd, nice.
Oh, definite foul.
Miguel just got knocked over.
Ah, these classical players...
Again.
These classical players are just playing really, really rough.
I especially saw that in the first half of the game.
Yeah.
A lot of gripping, a lot of knocking over, pushing fouls.
I mean, they have 4 fouls already in this half, I think, I believe.
I'm not sure.
And if that's true, then Gulamy only has one. But even if it's not, Classical has four fouls and Gulamy has one.
20. Great handling on Dylan.
There should have been a foul there.
Oh, knocked over by Kendall. Great job, Kendall. Miguel trying to get it out there. 1-4. Four probably shoot again. And he does.
He makes his second three of the game.
There's three there. What's the play?
Oh. Oh, yeah. Fair.
Number four warned for taunting.
These players are getting
full of themselves.
Oh, yeah, extremely. Especially number one.
But number four is the first one to get called for it.
Yeah, and they just think it's funny. I think number 33 might have got called for it, too.
I'm not quite sure. I think he's just in the way a lot. Miguel's ball pushing his way.
Miguel getting through.
Almost making his layup.
That would have been impressive.
It would have been a great play. Kind of just gave up on the ball when it was given to the Blacks. Four going again.
Number four.
Kenny.
Thinks he can take on anyone, it seems like, number four.
Couldn't shake off the
ball. Oh.
It's a great job on him.
20 lost the ball.
Page 33 pushing his way into the key.
Nope.
Foul.
Gonna be two free throws, but he didn't get the shot. Yeah, number four just needs to calm down. He's getting a little bit into his own head. He's trying to take on everyone and just trying to shoot the three. Make two threes and you think you can shoot anything and see it happen all the time. But he needs to calm down. 33 making his first shot.
Substitution.
Oh, Kendall coming
off. Kendall He was making some great plays. Hopefully we see him again later in this game.
This game looks like it's a little bit too far out of reach, but
he good effort with his points. Gulamy. Great job.
Good effort from Gulamy.
Miguel giving it to Lonzo here. Push his way into the key.
Oh, getting through.
Oh, almost. Oh, hit off of White.
That so looked like it was out of bounds before he even passed, but or it looked like he was out of bounds.
But now it's back ball.
Man, it really just seems like this Classical lineup is just stacked with seniors. Gulamy just doesn't have that luxury. And that's obviously...
We don't have that experience yet.
Yeah, and that's a really big difference in the playing styles.
Oh,
that's definite foul. Major charging there. A technical.
That was a technical. Charging. Got a technical. That's...
Yeah, he shoved him in the back. These Classical players have had it coming to them for a while, though. They've been really
aggressive.
Cocky.
I think they've been kind of running that no call.
Yeah, I mean, they really have. They've been making a lot of hard contact fouls that just have not been needed at all.
Eventually caught up to them now.
Yep.
Seeing that they have a technical.
And... For whatever reason, there's a big deal here. Not too sure why the Classical coach is confused. It was a pretty obvious foul. Pushing him in the back.
Just watching this, I think they've ever had a technical. Is this the first technical? I'm not sure. I haven't kept up with the previous games.
First technical of this game.
Yeah, definitely. A long process.
Miguel's gonna take the free throw.
He is?
Mm-hmm.
Get the free throw shot. Alright, let's see how this goes. Alright, Miguel for the first one.
Oh, Miguel with the free throw.
Perfect.
Yeah, Classical, they need to calm down. Miguel just needs to breathe and
take
a couple
his time.
Easy shots here.
Beautiful.
Impressive. He might be someone to really look out for on this team.
Yep, see, he's only a freshman. He's already making great plays.
Yeah, and another little guy that's going to be coming in is Tavon.
Indeed.
Very impressive.
That was
technical?
For
Classical. Double technical? Interesting.
Guess so. Having some technical difficulties here. Come on, we gotta think here.
I have no idea what's going on.
We have the rest. Well, there was a technical call on number 20. Black.
Right. The game's just... It's being called really odd.
I think there is a bit of a miscommunication between the refs. Because they keep kind of trumping their calls and they're kind of debating a little more. But I think we're back in this game again.
We're about to find out.
It was a double technical.
Interesting.
Interesting. Okay, well, we're back in this game. Miguel starting off here with us.
What?
Miguel just made both of his free throws.
Handle for him. Hopefully we get their heads in the game now. Dage
getting three.
Oh, but he coming in number four. Oh, but he loses the ball.
Number four loses the ball. Miguel got it.
Has the ball.
Oh.
Already a jump ball.
Black ball.
Dang.
That really should have been a Guhami ball. Miguel's confused.
But we'll see how the rest of this game plays out. Hopefully we get a little slightly cleaner game.
Number two hopped in a little bit late there. Oh,
and he almost tries to get past Dage. Dage is just keep his zone. 24 ounce ball. Little
shoot. Off. Very off. Air ball.
Hits the net. White ball. I have Khalil throwing it into me. Sorry. Yo here. Kendall's going to be substituted in here in a sec.
Whoa, Khalil. That was weird.
Kind of focusing on something else. Kenny. Kenny's been out with a, I think, broken collarbone for a while. So he hasn't had a lot of play time recently. Timeout called.
It was needed.
For Guhami. And we'll be back after this commercial break.
It's the most wonderful time of the year. With the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year. It's the happiest season of all. With those holiday greetings and gay happy meetings when friends come to call.
Wrestling.
We're back, Guhami. We have classical 39-18. And hopefully Guhami can bring it back these next two periods.
Miguel getting through. Wow.
Oh. 31 pressure and Kendall couldn't get a hold of the ball.
I don't think that's a Guhami ball, but I'm not gonna say anything. Let that slide.
Let that slide.
Here's Miguel.
Miguel throwing in.
Oh, it might have been a foul, actually, I think.
Maybe to Khalil. To Dage. Ooh. Dage takes the shot.
Bad shot.
Just short. Miguel taking the ball again. Passing it to Kendall. Kendall pushing it into the key, but gets smothered by 31 and 24. White ball again.
Number 24 wants a foul. I guess he got hit in the mouth, but lost in the confusion. Two hands on the
camera. Miguel looking for someone to be open. Kendall. But he's getting smothered around by people who are hitting him.
Yeah, he's getting battered in there. Taking a beating.
Kendall just can't find anyone open. Has no room to work with. So some great defense on classical, but ended in a foul. Let's see if Kendall makes these. Just short.
Outside of the rim.
Substitution, 33 coming in for, I believe, number
31. Nope.
Four.
Number four. Who got called for taunting
previously after making two threes.
Yes.
Impressive. Ooh, 21. Thank you, Kendall. Good point.
A technical again. On Dage.
Another technical. What is happening? For what? This is interesting.
I just asked Daniel why he got the why Dej got technical.
Messed up.
He said he
doesn't
know. 24 misses the free throw though. Yeah, I'm not too sure why that technical was given. Didn't see it. I'm assuming he pushed him in the back.
I guess. Is that enough for technical?
Yeah.
Alright, we're back in this game again. I've never seen that many technicals
so quickly.
And three technicals that quick.
Number two, pushing through.
Yeah, that's a foul. Yeah, he was holding on to him.
Yeah, I saw that.
The ref's going to talk to the coach, I'm imagining.
Classical getting kind of...
I'm not too sure what's going on right now. Classical getting some calls. Number 31 getting closed down. Oh. Go homie, ball. It goes off number one. How interesting.
I haven't seen a lot of action from number one recently. Hopefully it stays that way. Last thing homie needs is the front to come back.
Oh, I wanted to shoot.
Was gonna shoot.
Oh, Khalil wants it. He's wide open.
Kendall. Pac-Man posted. 33.
Yeah.
Foul.
Posted.
Kendall getting free throws now. 33.
Yeah, there was definite contact there.
Yeah.
These classical players, man. Too handsy.
Indeed. Getting too physical too fast.
I remember some of the soccer players saying that they were like that. The soccer team, too. Yep. And I remember classical being like this last year. They're just a really rough team, I guess. I'm not too sure why.
I guess it's just atmosphere.
Maybe.
One has the ball again. Hopefully he can cover him. He shoots for the three. Nope. Doesn't make it, luckily. 33, classical, drives in. Doesn't make the layup.
Bad shot there.
The shot, sorry. Classical doubling Guhomi's score here.
Yeah, but Classical really hasn't been scoring too many points. Neither has Guhomi, to be fair, but... A break in the scoring from Classical. Oh, well.
Taking a lick, huh? Should have knocked on wood there. It's Christian throwing it into Khalil here.
Yep, here's Khalil. Christian, looked like he wanted to shoot that. Here's Khalil. Miguel's going to shoot that, I'm imagining. No?
Oh, wide open. Kendall was in the... Did no one see?
Just a wide open layup.
You got hit on the head, but I guess
he
didn't get called. 33 just keeps opening to Kendall, I think.
Yeah, 33's...
Doesn't make the shot, luckily. Miguel has the ball.
33 is not really able to make shots, but he's able to make layups. I mean...
Miguel showed some great strengths for Guhomi.
Yeah.
Moving in and out from seniors on the other team. Pass Miguel. Shoot. Oh, almost. Beautiful plays.
He's number one on the ball.
You think he'll push it, or do you think he'll pass it to someone?
No, he's going to pass it.
Good on him. Kendall, great defense.
Wow.
Oh, makes the shot.
That was a great layup. It was there for him the whole time. Kendall wasn't too physical, and that was good. If he would have been any more physical there, it probably would have warranted a foul, but...
That is true. That is true.
Miguel wants the ball. Yep, he's going
to... Oh,
yeah. That was... Yeah, black number one. That was definitely... He's kind of getting in his face a little bit.
Substitution in here. 11 for 33.
It's just such a cluster if you look at the court right now.
He's using some miscommunication on both teams here.
Especially among the refs.
Griffin. Oh, get that shot, Letta.
Not really keeping a good hold on this game.
Yeah, they are. Let's see how this plays out. And we're having some talks between refs and coaches again. Good job, Miguel.
Miguel's making all these free throws, man. I'm impressed.
Bright future for him, bright future for Guhomi if he decides to stay.
He's definitely a good player.
We do have great players here in Guhomi, but I just think we need a better team. Hey, like, you know.
You know who the last person to wear the salmon colored shoes was?
What?
The last person to wear salmon colored shoes on this team was Christian.
New Christian? Question mark? Potential?
I don't know.
We'll find out. If we're getting some listeners.
He's sitting next to Christian. Christian's giving him a little hug.
Give him a little pep talk.
He's a freshman. He's going to be tutored and he's going to develop.
Coach isn't seeming very happy.
And Coach is looking at us when he's talking.
Dylan from Guhomi has a foul. And the ref's calling. All right, black ball. Let's see how this goes.
And Guhomi with $6. Classical with $8.
Oh, one couldn't get the ball.
Even he said, ooh. He's getting guarded well by Christian, actually. They're shutting him down.
Great job.
Number one is being shut down.
Good. They learned from the previous half that probably should learn a little sooner.
I don't think he scored this half yet. I mean, at least not this quarter. No,
I haven't even seen a lot of playing time out of him.
No.
Well, that's good. They don't need.
He might not last.
Him dominating the court like last time.
He might not last too long.
Endurance, maybe?
Three wide open.
Three pushing his way through. Not a travel.
Oh, what a definite slap on the arm. I could hear that.
Yeah, he kind of echoed through the court a little bit.
Got up there when he shot that ball, though.
Good on him pushing his way through. Take some perseverance.
Dylan's going to come in for Christian. Gohani player's just looking dejected. I can't blame them. This game really... None of this game has gone in their favor.
Oh, no, it's Dylan for Khalil.
Yeah, point guard for point guard, but...
Makes sense. What were we saying?
This game just hasn't gone in Gohani's favor with the calls, with the chaotic reffing that they've had.
And the aggressive plays from high school.
It's just... I don't know, man. Unneeded aggression by Classical.
Exactly, that's about to say that.
At least from our great job perspective.
Good shot by Dage.
And I'm pretty sure the coach sees it that way too.
Wow.
What a powerful pass.
What a pass.
Take the shot. Don't think it's going to make it again.
Nope.
Well, that was 24.
24 is a lot bigger than most of our players that are in the key.
Yeah, he's strong.
So he can kind of push his way through to make his shots.
Oh, Lonzo with
Lonzo
the hand
coming in. Oh.
Oh,
doesn't make the layup close.
That was
though. Nearly
very
impression.
Impression?
Very impressive.
It's gonna be two shots though. Obvious free throws. Lonzo.
Well, hey guys, don't forget Club Hope is hosting a food drive December 10th through the 20th. Drop off canned and non-perishable foods in the office, upper high school, lower high school, middle school building, Miss Ukrainian's room, and Miss Trans.
Lonzo made the second free throw.
You may also know them as previously Hash Club, but name has changed to Hope.
Yes.
Not sure if it's an acronym. So, I do think that Guahome is going to come through these next few games. I think this being their first home game, kind of showing them the support they have from the crowd and from each other, that they'll grow up.
Support I don't think it'll be the crowd.
Well, I mean, we did have occasional, you know, from the girls.
Yeah.
But I do think having Classical fans here more than Guahome does affect their spirit a little
bit. Yeah. Can't blame them. Messy free throw, but it went in. And here's Dylan. Looks like
Christian.
Lonzo was trying to get in there, and Christian.
Christian.
Yep. Lonzo.
Lonzo. Oh, almost made the layup.
It was nearly good.
Black ball.
Okay, so we got 1-1. 24, not too sure what to do with it. Lonzo's getting subbed out.
Lonzo holding.
He played during that JV game, too.
Oh, I'm sure he's extremely tired. Yeah.
Yeah. I'm sure a lot of these players are, man.
Yeah, especially... Perfect. All right. I would say... Dave just seen a lot of action here.
Yeah, he has. So is Miguel.
Yeah, for a freshman.
He's been Christian, too. Christian's really been in quite a bit.
Yeah. And they're playing extremely well for the amount of time they've been in this game.
Yeah. It's tough, man, because we don't have a lot of players this year.
Yeah, they don't have a lot of subs to keep a consistent game against their team. Classical, which is just stacked with people.
Yeah, we are what we were last year, but that's okay. It happens.
You see Miguel taking free throws again. I have faith in him. I have faith in him.
I mean, he should make one, if not both of them. There's one.
Beautiful.
He's really good on these free throws. It's a skill. Definitely. Khalil's coming on here for Kenny. And here's his second free throw.
Great asset.
Of course.
He's looking good for this team. I really do hope to see more of him. 1-24.
Wide open.
Spun through. He's pushing his way. Doesn't make the layup. It's one thing to be flashy when you get up there, but if you don't make the point, then it's...
And it really wasn't a good layup either. It was an air ball.
Here's Dylan pushing his way up.
Oh, beautiful.
Makes the layup. Great job.
He's the one
kind of wheezing his way. I think 31 wants to be subbed. He's like, I got hit.
Not sure yet.
Oh, okay, he can breathe now. Don't worry, guys.
32 is coming in. I have not seen him all game.
Kendall coming in. Looking forward to this. Coming in for Dage, number 44, little homie. Here we go, Dylan.
Here's Dylan for his third possible point. Oh, Khalil, though.
Great rebound. White ball knocked out from number one. Score, 52-29. Classical lead.
Number one's trying to get involved again.
Miguel going to get the key to Kendall.
And
great layup. Kendall's really making a consistent amount of his shots and layups.
We got an entire another quarter.
And I think we could rally, dude. I think there's potential. Or at least to get closer. To show that we're not done here. And that's the end of this game. And we'll be back after this commercial break.
We all know what it is. But do we all know how it works and where it came from? Wrestling has been around for as long as humans have been around. It is in the Iliad, the Bible, and has even been found in cave drawings in France. It has also been in the first Olympic Games, and as a matter of fact, also in our high school. Let's see what our Guhomi wrestlers are doing now and how they expect to do in the future.
I'm Brandon Raymer. I'm the captain of the wrestling team, and I'm a senior. I've been in wrestling for 7 years now, fourth year at Guhomi. Last year, I went to Masters. I got third at CIF, had an overall score of 28 wins, 10 losses, and I also won league. I feel like we're going to be very successful. We obviously have a lot of new kids on the team also, so there's a lot of room for improvement and everything, a lot of underclassmen. But I feel confident that we should have at least 5 people go to CIF and place and continue on to Masters. Well, one obvious goal for the team is to win league, because that's obviously like...
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back. We're here. We have some... Our girls' basketball team back from their game. What was it? 65-22? Is that the score?
Yes.
Great plays. Great 55. Plays.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. 65-22. I thought you were talking about this game.
No.
Oh, wow. Dylan. Bad pass there by 33.
Luckily, we get...
Dylan going all the way through.
Dylan going all the way through. Cutting it.
Dylan.
Rebound by Kendall.
Good job, Kendall.
Layup. Great play. Sophomore to sophomore.
A 19-point game. Guhomi closing the 20-point gap for the first time in a while.
Good job by Christian.
Shove the ball out of bounds.
It's black ball.
Yeah.
Really?
I thought...
Oh, my bad.
It went off Christian. He pushed out of bounds. Number two trying to find space. Just barely.
Dylan not trying to get contact.
Interesting pass there by number two.
Oh, Dylan with a steal.
Tries it to Khalil.
Khalil into the key.
Blocking. Yeah. Two free throws. Blocking foul there.
Called on to 11? I can't tell.
Yeah, I think it was number 11.
Taking your time.
Khalil. Sorry, though. That was weird. Khalil.
We need Miguel. We need Miguel. Miguel, come back.
Oh, Will, so close both times, man.
Oh, he gets it back.
Oh, but he gets the rebound. 11 sneaking in there.
Oh, but he gets the steal back. Great play by Khalil there. Dylan to Kendall. Back to Khalil.
Oh, he wanted to shoot that so bad.
But 11 was pressuring him too hard.
Dage wants it. Dage is wide open.
He was some great covering. Oh, Dage is perp. Oh, wish Kendall had some Dage there. Oh, luckily Dylan did.
Easy.
Dage gets an easy, easy shot.
Dage is going to make that all day.
He can do that consistently right now.
Your classical is getting shaky right now.
Black ball. Classical is getting very shaky. Some mistakes. Timeout call them black.
Yeah, they need that.
We'll be back after this commercial break.
It's the most wonderful time of the year. With the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year. It's the happiest season of all. With those holiday greetings and gay happy meetings when friends come to call.
Wrestling, we all know what it is, but do we all know how it works and where it came from? Wrestling has been around for as long as humans have been around. It is in the Iliad, the Bible, and has even been found.
Guys, don't sleep on us, we're back! Don't forget!
Yeah, don't sleep on us.
Don't sleep on us, please.
Classical's coming in with their full strength lineup again. They were getting weird there.
Yeah, they're
choking a little bit, but
here we go.
Oh, Deej.
Well, that is kind of interesting.
They come back and they're starting again.
Wow.
Kendall at the in the right place at the right time.
Wow.
Amazing play by Guhomi.
Number 11 getting shut down.
Classical getting kind of worried there.
Oh my word, what is going on?
The ball, what is happening?
The cluster.
Jump ball. Unfortunately, it's black, though.
Classical choking.
So that's why they brought back their starting lineup. They got kind of insecure about their lead.
Yeah, their lead's cut down, man.
Yeah, what was it before?
15 point now?
It was 22. We're coming through, but one pushing. But luckily, we only learned to cover.
11 shooting.
Not going to make it. That.
And he shouldn't be shooting threes when this game's that close.
They need
rebound get by Christian there.
When it's this close, you can't be taking
no
shots like that. You have to be consistent.
You're
injured.
He didn't go.
He
did.
Khalil with a three.
Oh! Khalil with a three.
52 to 40.
When he's good.
Homie, let's get this.
But
he's exactly good with the wide open three. Khalil, 12-point lead for Classical.
24, gonna try to push in, but Dage is doing some great defense.
The block,
he got slapped.
Oh, travel!
I have no idea what is happening right now, ladies and gentlemen.
Dorsey Bunnett's coming from the back. We're good for that rally.
This has been a 10-point comeback so far.
Insane rally.
How much time do we have left?
We have about 5 minutes and 50 seconds.
We can do this easy.
As long as we keep our head in the game, keep our communication up. Look at Khalil, Khalil's wide open.
Now cut them out. They go inside.
But Kendall, oh, didn't make the layup. Dylan.
Oh, he's got
Dylan,
everyone
Dylan
on him.
Ah, for 24.
Yeah, they were definitely fouled there. They didn't call it, but contact.
Number four, he's going to try to go up. Dage
is just waiting for him.
Saw the players coming in. Oh,
foul.
Set up for the shot.
You can't be making mistakes like this. Each point they get makes our job, or Guhomi's job.
I don't agree with Savannah. We're playing way too much wrestling commercials. Like,
We only have so many.
We got to play something else, man. We could play that introduction to sports story that we made. Where we met with...
Or, you know... Oh, we could, yeah. Okay, yeah. Well, next live stream.
Something else, man.
Yeah, it's on repeat. And speaking of which... Speaking of which,
I'm gonna talk.
If you want us to make ads for you, just contact MyDA at MyDA@Guhomi.net to make ads for you. We'll come to you and film. We need that sponsorship so we can eventually live stream soccer. That's the goal here. Khalil for the shot, for the three. Oh, he makes the three! Amazing shot. Now a 10-point lead Classical has.
Khalil?
Almost, yeah. Khalil, another three.
Oh, my word!
No! He's back.
It's not gonna count.
It's not gonna count though, but
no, they're fighting for it.
But we can see that Khalil can make these constant threes. Making a number four taunt for Classical a little less, you know.
Hats off to Khalil, man.
20 through
Dage.
Oh, back pass.
Can't get it.
Layup.
Okay. Finally make some points here.
Hopefully this is consistent. We have just under 5 minutes left of this game, and hopefully Guhomi can take back this lead.
Lonzo.
And I think they can. Oh, one. One's playing a little aggressive again. Dylan for the shot. Doesn't make it. Knocked out.
Out. White
ball. Should be a Guhomi ball. It is a white ball. Fantastic. See, this is the communication we needed.
I wish they would have taken Khalil out because he's on fire right now, and he needs to keep that momentum.
That's 3 threes in a row. It is risky to take those shots, but if you can make them consistently, it's good.
Oh, definite foul.
One end in disbelief, but contact's pretty obvious.
Oh, it was a foul.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm not sure what that was.
Okay.
Hit.
The ref pointed.
One was pulling.
Yeah.
Dylan.
I don't think that ref likes us too well.
Maybe not.
Oh,
yeah. Here we go. Let's go.
11-point game.
Costco's still in the lead. Coach.
Coach wanted to talk to the ref, but the ref says not coach. Right now.
It's like, I'm kind of busy right now.
Yeah,
man.
The classical coach is...
kind of nervous, I think.
Extremely. Dylan?
Dylan has made the last throw. One has the ball again. Hopefully, Guhoma can cover him.
He's not going to pass.
No.
He's way not too good. Selfish.
23. Pushing.
Dylan. Number one's way too selfish Dylan. On the ball, though.
Yeah, making it dangerous.
Momentum kind of getting shut down by Guhoma here. Or for Guhoma, rather.
Two free throws.
I'm assuming he should make them.
Wow.
Maybe his momentum a little bit off, too.
Kind of got his mojo thrown around.
Miguel up waiting for the ball.
It's Miguel. Miguel's in.
Yep, it's good. 20-4 back covering.
Makes the last one. Making it 11-point lead for Classical again.
12.
But I do have faith in Guhoma to bring it back.
12-point lead.
Dave.
Oh?
Oh, it is 12. Apologies.
Dage.
Dage making the layup. And he's picking points. This is what we need.
Man.
One play aggressive, pushing so back and forth.
Oh, Dage has the ball with a 5-foot jump ball.
Definite foul on number one.
White ball. White ball. Definite foul on number one. He's getting too handsy. He just needs to calm down, really.
He's worried about the...
He's worried about losing.
The distance between them now, and he's keeping it in his head that he has to play solo, which isn't the case. Dage again. Another layup. Let's go, Dage.
Number one. Look at him. He's worried.
We can't get in our head that we're getting these points. We need to play smart.
And this is the Guhoma that we saw all last season. This is the Guhoma we saw all last season. The competitive spirit. The comebacks late on.
More free
coaches on the court.
I think Dylan's going to be taken off here. Dylan's been fouling too
not
much.
Not sure why there was free throws.
Dylan pushed four. Huh? Dylan pushed four, I believe.
Oh, okay.
Oh, they're not taking off Dylan. Oh, they're taking off Dage!
Kendall's coming on now.
Okay, Kendall, yeah, he's been making some great plays and really helping out the team.
And I'm assuming number four is not going to make this free throw. Maybe he will. Yeah, I didn't think so.
Who is this? White ball. All right, we'll take it. I'll take it.
The rim.
Dylan has the ball. We have his support from Guhoma.
Just under 4 minutes.
Khalil has the ball. Back to Dylan.
A 9-point game.
Miguel. Khalil, wide open.
Oh!
Well. 4 for 4.
4 for 4.
Watch one. He has the ball. Be careful.
He's getting too full of himself. Look at him. He's not passing.
He's not passing.
That's travel.
Intense travel call there, but it was not called. Dylan making the layup. Getting back those quick points. Only have a 6-point lead now.
Number one's like, who do I pass to?
Just over 3 minutes. I think Guhoma has enough momentum to keep this going. But 20 makes it layup.
Easy layup.
Guhoma can keep this up. They just have to improve their defense.
No,
foul.
Yeah.
He's got white ball.
Number one. He's going crazy.
Oh, here we go.
Yeah, Dylan has two free throws.
Come on, Dylan. Keep your head in this game.
Don't
8-point game. He needs to make both of these.
It's 8.
Oh,
we really need to keep this in reach.
We're at 6, and I think we can keep coming back and then eventually take the lead. Let's go!
Smooth as butter for him. Great free throw. Lonzo's coming off.
Oh, for Dave
and
Dave.
Kendall. They're going to be passing into the key a lot here.
And use those layups.
I think they're really expecting Dylan to make the second.
Oh, Dylan!
Yeah,
beautiful layup again.
And they're expecting him to make that second free throw because they got two big men.
Really aggressive. But luckily Christian's on him. Christian's been
losing
the handle.
One's struggling here.
He's choking. Seems like his ego is kind of struggling a little bit after Tyler too.
They should be calling fouls here on number 20. I've seen multiple.
Christian has the ball again. Back to Dylan. Dylan back to Khalil. Khalil's wide open. To Dage. Khalil.
Good. Oh, he wanted to take it. Dylan working his way in.
Oh, should have been a foul there. 24 has the ball. Dylan wanting that ball back, but one. Tight pressure again.
Just over 2 minutes here. It's only 8 points.
One's going to try to drive his way through. Oh, but he chokes. And off him. White ball now.
One's frustrated.
Huh?
One's frustrated with himself.
We got kind of lacking now.
Yeah.
The timeout call, I believe. We'll be back after this commercial break.
Wrestling. We all know what it is.
Whether it's not wanting to run or work out, wear funny-looking clothing or sweat, many people's responses are, ugh, more PE. On the other hand, there's the people that like to run and maintain a healthy body. Some people aren't athletes like others, but you don't need to be athletic to succeed in PE, because it isn't only about working out and running. According to fitworld.org, PE improves your physical fitness, develops motor skills, teaches self-discipline, influences leadership and cooperation, and most importantly, it keeps you physically and mentally healthy. According to shapeamerica.org, 74.5% of the states require PE from elementary to high school. Only 6 states require PE in every grade. 28 states allow waivers, which for many means, yay, no PE. But is this really how we should react to physical education? Can this be changed? Does PE really benefit not only us now, but also our future? Let's go talk to some PE teachers to get their perspective on this topic.
Hi, I'm Mr. Mormon, high school PE teacher here. PE.
We're back from our commercial break. What you just saw was Mr. Mormon, our athletic director.
Full strength line is being played by both teams. It would seem.
No one's messing around now. Costco still has an 8-point lead. We're immediately back in this game.
Just under 2 minutes.
Dylan pushing in. Oh, travel. You can't make so many mistakes like that. They add up, especially now.
Number one.
One. Oh, he's passing it now. Oh, but 20 has the ball.
Kendall. He's getting through.
Kendall getting the ball. Great rebound. Dylan.
They need to lower number 20 on that flank.
Yeah. Oh. When he see me, seems to be.
Oh!
Another travel again.
Dylan. Wow.
Two times in a row. Need to watch for that. Oh, sorry. 1.5 minutes here.
The pressure is on.
Khalil playing extra defensive. Doesn't want
to
take a shot.
Start shooting threes.
Oh, a bad shot. Oh, but 33 just gets in there and makes his layup. Give him a 10-point lead.
They might be out of reach here now.
Seeming that way, but I do have faith in Guhami that we'll get this rally.
Go to Manley.
Kendall in the right place at the right time. Oh, but doesn't make the layup. Four has the ball. Passes it to number one. Dage kind of fumbles between his legs there.
Number one actually passed.
Oh,
not the best shot.
Doesn't make the three they wanted to.
They need to work the ball up quick.
We need to be a little faster. We have just under a minute here. 24 yelling to throw off Dylan. Not very sportsman. Another timeout called by Guhami here. And we'll be back after this commercial break.
Whether it's not wanting to run or work out, wear funny-looking clothing or sweat, many people's responses are, ugh, more PE. On the other hand, there's the people that like to run and maintain a healthy body. Some people aren't athletes like others, but you don't need to be athletic to succeed in PE, because it isn't only about working out and running. According to fitworld.org, PE improves your physical fitness, develops motor skills, teaches self-discipline, influences leadership and cooperation, and most importantly, it keeps you physically and mentally healthy. According to shapeamerica.org, 74.5% of the states require PE from elementary to high school. Only 6 states require PE in every grade. 28 states allow waivers, which for many means, yay, no PE. But is this really how we should react to physical education? Can this be changed? Does PE really benefit not only us now, but also our future? Let's go talk to some PE teachers to get their perspective on this topic.
We're
Hi, Mr. Mormon, high school PE teacher here. PE absolutely helps you maintain a healthy lifestyle, teaching you the basics of nutrition, fundamentals.
We're back, homie. Let's see how the rest of this game plays out. We're just under a minute here.
All right.
With a 10-point lead. I think it is possible.
A lot of threes, I'm assuming.
All or nothing now.
They shouldn't be shooting twos. Well,
Gage are making the layup. Good. This is good. As long as Rodgers holds onto the ball for too long,
Classico is going to be sitting on the ball here.
Yeah, that's the smartest move right now.
Wasting time.
But White, one was way too open there.
Oh.
Don't want to get... Dylan.
Oh! That was dirty. That was dirty.
Good Mormon kind of... Oh, man. Every second here is valuable.
Yep.
All right, set up for the free throw shot.
They're calling a block. They're calling a block on Kendall. I did...
Really?
I did not see that. I just saw...
Yeah.
I just saw...
Is that what you hold in basketball?
Stuff? Extreme block, but... Oh, Kendall. I'm not too sure why that.
Christian's going to win. Hopefully he doesn't make any of these.
It's a close game. Even if Guajami loses, they should be proud.
Yeah, they came back, and they came back strong. Great plays, too.
7-point game, though. It's not without... It's not out of their reach. It's a couple threes.
It's just a learning experience for them. He makes a shot. White ball, passes it to Christian. Christian to Miguel. Miguel gets the ball for a three.
Oh, for the three.
Oh, bad shot.
He should have settled there.
I think it's the time. 20 has it.
20
makes a layup.
That was an easy layup there. And that's for the not watching. It was a fast break.
End of the game. Great job on Guajami plays, but Classical comes out on top.
Impressive. Yeah, Classical was getting worried there, and you could really tell.
Because they started up with their lineup again.
Yeah, I don't think they should really be proud of that win.
They had some questionable plays and some questionable things.
Yeah, number one very questionable guy.
24 yelling on sportsmanlike, but, you know, those things happen. But great job, great performance from both teams. And I hope Guajami learns from this game, plays to their strengths, and learns from their weaknesses.
Number one. I didn't know someone could be so full of themselves on the court. I mean, not to be rude or anything, but he just didn't pass.
I mean, as a senior, maybe he was looking out for
the
college.
There's seniors on the team, too.
Exactly. Should have given them some
yellow out, yeah.
But things to learn from. Thank you, everyone, listening into this live stream tonight. I've been Griffin.
I've been Gunner.
And we're signing out.